Değerli basın
Distinguished members of the press,
1 Ekim 2014 tarihinde
on 1st of October 2014, Mr. Jens Stoltenberg has taken over the duty of Secretary General of NATO, and we are very pleased to be able to host him in our country. And after having taken over his tenure, he first visited Poland, and his second visit is to Turkey. The important developments that have been taking place on the south and northern part, on the east and southern part of NATO have been taken into consideration during our visit, and we do believe it is a very timely visit. Once again, we would like to say welcome, and during the visit, the Secretary General will be having meetings with the President of the Republic, the Prime Minister, and also the Minister of National Defense and the Chief of General Staff. This is an era where we have important issues for the international fora, and during this tenure, the Secretary General has a very important task indeed. And his experience from his former positions, we do believe, will guide him in a successful manner throughout this very difficult task ahead of him. And as Turkey, we would like to wish Mr. Stoltenberg success, and we would like to extend our supporting hand to Mr. Stoltenberg during his tenure. The tete-a-tete, as well as the meetings between the delegations, we talked about the new threats of the Islamic State and the developments in Syria and Iraq, and also the security problems of the region, as well as the NATO actions in this region and the importance of NATO in this region. We also talked about the terrorism threat in the region and the necessity of having a comprehensive strategy to tackle with this. And we have also agreed that ISIS is an important threat in the Middle East. And we also talked about the humanitarian dimensions of the crisis in our border. As you know, Turkey is hosting many immigrants from Syria and Iraq. There are more than 1.5 million people from Syria and Iraq, and this is a very big burden on the shoulder of Turkey, and this was another issue which we discussed together with the Secretary General. In September, the NATO summit took place in Wales, and we also talked about the conclusions of that visit, and we talked on the issue of the support of our country on a bilateral manner, as well as in the NATO framework to Ukraine. We also talked about the Crimean Tatar Turks. I provided information to the Secretary General on this and expressed our sensitivities, and we also shared the information on the dialogue we have with Russia on this issue. And we also talked about the mission of the OSCE in this region. And the ISIAF is going to be concluding its tenure in Afghanistan, and with this support we have extended, we also talked about the preparations for the transition period, which was an important item of our agenda. The Afghan authorities, as long as they request, we will continue to render support to the Afghan nation. And we also expressed that we have a long-term commitment for Afghanistan. This was an issue I conveyed to the Secretary General. I would also like to once again wish success to the Secretary General in his new tenure. And on 2nd and 3rd of December, we will once again meet in Brussels in the NATO Foreign Ministers meeting. Turkey has always paid an important contribution to this region, as well as to the international affair. Thank you very much. Once again, the floor is yours, Mr. Secretary General.
Thank you so much, Minister Çavuşoğlu, and I appreciate very much the hospitality you have shown me and my delegation, and we have just finished a delicious and a very rich Turkish breakfast, and I appreciate very much that we had this opportunity to go through a lot of different issues. I'm very glad to come to Turkey, the second ally I visit as the Secretary General of NATO. And Turkey is a key ally. Turkey is a strong ally. So I'm making this trip at the start of my tenure to consult with you and to hear about your efforts and your concerns at these challenging times, to show solidarity of the alliance as we face security challenges both to the south and to the east of our alliance, and to discuss the implementation of the decisions of the Wales summit to keep NATO strong, to keep help our neighborhoods stable by working with partners, and to keep the bond between Europe and North America rock solid. Minister, we have consulted on the situation in the region, which we monitor very closely. ISIL poses a grave threat to the Iraqi people, to the Syrian people, to the wider region, and to NATO nations. So it is important that the whole international community stays united in this long-term effort. I welcome the decisive actions taken by the United States with many allies and partners, and I welcome the recent vote in the Turkish Parliament to authorize an even more active role of Turkey in the crisis. NATO is playing its role. Our Patriot deployment reinforces Turkey's air defense, and it helps protect Turkish territory and citizens against missile attacks. NATO stands ready to support all allies in defending their security. For many decades, Turkey has been a steadfast ally, contributing to our collective defense and to the stability of the region. Your armed forces are making a significant contribution in Kosovo and in Afghanistan. We will continue to count on Turkey in Afghanistan. Next year, you will be one of the framework nations as part of a new mission to train, advise, and assist the Afghan forces. And we are working together to ensure that we can launch the mission on January 1st as planned. At our Wales summit, we took important decisions. We are now turning those decisions into reality. So I look forward to continue working with Turkey to keep NATO the bedrock of our security.